Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Get Dumped, episode 3. We still don't have internet, so I'm recording this and I hope it gets out as soon as possible when I get a good internet connection. So, I'm just gonna make, one more video of this and prepare it for the time the internet comes on. Oh, it's really loud. Hold on. Okay, here we go. As soon as I got home, I went to sleep. I felt very drained from everything and I just needed some rest. Oh yeah, in the previous episode, we got bitch slapped by a freaking bitch. Michi, wait up. I organized a group date and I was wondering if you want to come. You asking me? Does she think me and Aura broke up already? Okay. Thinking those thoughts made me sad. It was like no one had faith in our relationship. Michi, think about the offer, huh? The girl took a step back. Kisa was infamously popular for her beauty and sharp tongue. It was no wonder she was scared. But why did Kisa stop me? Would you like to come too? I'll see. Well, I don't have much homework tonight, so the timing of this event's pretty good. But I could also be doing many other things with my time. Watch Arashi's game, go home, or go to the group date. This is gonna be very difficult to choose. I don't know what to do. Okay, go with the group date. Wow, who cares about Arashi's game? Who cares about that dude's game? We'll just go on a date or something, I don't know. Yeah, okay, I'll go. Sounds like a ton of fun. I'll show Aura that I don't need him to have a good time. Yay, thanks for agreeing with it even though it's so last minute. I'll go too then. Oh, okay, the more the merrier. Let's go. Now? Yep, it was today. Some girls couldn't come because they weren't feeling well. She guided up to a group of girls who had their makeup already. Wow, they sure are excited about this, but I guess it's only normal since they're all boyfriend hunting with this. Sounds like an excuse not to go. Kisa, be nice. One day, and I feel like it. Okay, as expected, the guys were nowhere near my Arashi. It's not like they were ugly, but I was disappointed nevertheless. Wow, you're pretty much saying they're ugly. In total, there are about 16 people. What? 16 people? So it was pretty large. It was a pretty large group date. You mean it's like an octuple? What's the word? Like octuplets? No, octuple date or something like that. I know for a fact I got the word wrong, but it's something to do with 8. You know, like you know, you get double dates, triple dates, quadruple dates. Well, I'm sure there's a word for having 8 dates. No, it has to be 6 dates then, cause... No. 7 dates. Cause... I don't know. Okay, I'm getting way into this. Wow. We went to San... Good. A good off of the guys were eyeing Kisa, but she was too busy texting her boyfriend to pay attention to them. Halfway through, I started to feel like I wasn't myself anymore. My body was moving on its own. Don't let this touch your soul. I sang my art and everyone stared at me like I was crazy. Wait, that was singing? Oh. Damn it, I can't go back. Sorry. I was gonna sing it. I just thought that was a simple statement, but I had no idea it was a song. Gosh darn it. I'm gonna sing it again. What was the words? Don't let this touch your soul or something. Don't let this touch your soul. Is that right? Don't let this touch your soul. Don't let this touch your soul. Okay, I guess that's it. I sang my ass out, and everyone stared at me like I was crazy, including Kisa. Not long after, I suddenly fainted. Michi, I could still vaguely hear Kisa's voice calling out to me, but couldn't move my body. She reeks of alcohol. Wait, was she drinking? A mistake, seriously. I'll get you fired. You think you'd be excused because you knew? I could see you right now. Seemed like a little waiter accidentally gave me some alcohol to drink from the neighboring group, thinking it was what I ordered. Damn you, waiter! Damn you! So it was the waiter that mistakenly gave me alcohol. Well, now I fear of waiters mistakenly giving me alcohol at restaurants. What a great new fear. I feel sleepy. You're in trouble. She lifted her laptop on my lap and opened a blog. There it was, filled with pictures of me being extremely drunk and crazy. Holy... I look so shameless and... yeah. Sorry I wasn't more assertive in stopping you. You were acting weird, but I didn't know you were drunk. I asked you whether you were fine doing it, but... I can't even remember half the things in these pictures. There was one where my hair was flying all over the place and I stood on the table pretending to play the guitar. And one where I tried to bite a girl's head. Scrolling down just made my jaw drop more and more. But isn't it illegal to post pictures of me like this? Supposedly, but it is passable. See? They even censored out your eyes. She was right. Anyone who didn't know me wouldn't be able to recognize me. Yeah, right. Come on, just taking out your eyes. People can still point you out. It's not a big deal, you know? People can still point you out and find you, even if your eyes are blocked out in a photo. But still, people who know you will be able to tell. Oh my god. I'm so embarrassed. I don't think I can walk outside in broad daylight again. How unlucky for me to get the alcoholic drink. My life might be ruined because of this. Well, good news is, I checked on F-Book. Oh my gosh. F-Book. I checked on F-Book, and no one seemed to post anything about it up. So no one I know has seen it yet. Thank goodness. Is there a way to remove the post? Well, I've reported it several times. If it doesn't work out, I'm gonna get my boyfriend to act in the account and disable it. Kisa, thank you. Don't. It's partially my fault it ended up like this, so I'm just taking responsibility. I feel horrible. Was this what a hangover was? It was just one drink. I must have had low alcohol tolerance. I sighed and laid on my bed again. Hopefully the issue would be resolved before it spreads to my school. Day 6. Wow. It was a Saturday, which was usually the day I kicked back and enjoyed. I was the type of leave homework until Sunday. Hey, that's like me. Well, I used to leave it on the last minute, but, you know, same thing. Bad habits were really hard to kill. But the big date, is tomorrow, so I might not have time then. Just 2 hours of TV. I turned on the television that I rarely use. Oh, brings back my childhood memories. Nowadays, it's all about the internet. Cable was forgotten somewhere. At least for me. And today we present Miss Turkey. You're to teach us how to make the next item. A cooking show? Ha! Mom must have been watching. And Mom loved to cook. For new dishes to make. Just as I was about to switch channels. It's a cute and delicious lunchbox that even beginners can make. Example pictures of the product floating across the screen. Wow, looks so nice. It's making me hungry. This is why you stay away from cooking channels. What should I do? Record it, change channel, ask my mom to cook it. Well, based on previous interactions, she really hates me asking her those stuff. So you know what? I'ma record it. Let's record this so I can reference it later. Now where's that record button? This could come really handy. I was thinking of making Ara a lunchbox tomorrow. This is perfect. I carefully watched and studied how Miss Turkey did it. They didn't lie. It seemed really simple. I bet I'd have no problem making one. Well, I guess if I want to do this week's homework will have to wait. Night seemed to come faster than usual. What was I doing this whole day? I have to prepare for tomorrow's date. I can't mess this up. This is what I've been working for the whole week. It honestly felt almost like a heavily weighted final exam. Right, let's make this date a success. First, bring lunch tomorrow. They said you can win a man through their stomach. What should I do about tomorrow's lunch? Make sandwiches, make a lunchbox, buy food from stores. You know what? Make a sandwich. Go to the kitchen and make a dish. Not the best cook, so I should go with the safe option. Sandwiches are easy to prepare and looks nice. Although it may not seem very elaborate, but it's still a classic. Maybe I should pack in a cute basket and have a romantic picnic. Just kidding. What am I imagining? The cherry blossoms aren't even out yet. Even though it sounds nice, the bugs would probably be too distracting. Next is outfits. I've learned a thing or two about fashion in the past week. I can't stick with my normal style because I really want to surprise Aura. With this date, I want to show him sides of me, inside and out, that he's never seen before. Okay, what should I do? Which style should I go for this date? Neon and retro, formal and neat, frilly and cute. To be honest, I'm not really into the frilly and cute. It depends on how frilly and how cute. Because sometimes it could be too frilly and could be too revealing. Neon and retro, I don't know. Let's go with formal and neat. It's best to go with classic styles in the hand. Who doesn't like a formal and neat style? It's both stylish and nice looking. After packing my outfit, I double checked to see if everything was there. It's all perfect. There's no way I can mess this up. I'll never forgive myself if I do. Okay, I'm gonna end this video over here. I don't want to, make the video really long. Thanks so much for watching. Take care. Bye.